alternating EMF given by E equals E naught sine omega t. Alternating EMF keeps on changing periodically with time in magnitude as well as in direction. How does it change in magnitude? EMF, induced EMF increases from 0 to a certain maximum value E naught, then again decreases to 0 from its maximum value. Then the direction of EMF is reversed, and again it increases from 0 to a certain to the same negative value, then decreases to 0. This is alternating EMF. So what is the realization? What is in real this increase and decrease and this reversal of EMF? What is this in real? What is actually happening in the circuit? Let us try to understand. I draw two circuits. One circuit containing a source of constant EMF and a bulb. It is a normal bulb. Okay. Now I connected it to a source of constant EMF, source of steady EMF, simply a battery. All the kind of cells and batteries are source of constant EMF. A source of constant EMF, simply a cell or a battery, a normal bulb, and a galvanometer in series. Obviously, there must be a switch S. This is galvanometer, and this one is bulb, a normal bulb. What happens when I switch it? When I switch on, when I close the circuit, what will happen? It will start glowing, the bulb will start glowing, and galvanometer shows a deflection. Right? Now what I have done, I have placed two cameras. One in front of the bulb, shooting the brightness of bulb, and the other shooting the movement of this galvanometer, the needle of galvanometer. Correct. Kuch nahi hai, tension matlab. एक कैमरा मैंने बल्ब के सामने लगाया, एक कैमरा मैंने गैल्वेनोमीटर के सामने लगाया, कैमरा रिकॉर्डिंग शुरू कर दी और स्विच मैंने ऑन किया. ओके, अब इस रिकॉर्डेड वीडियो को हम देख रहे हैं स्लो मोशन में. कैमरा वन, कैमरा टू. कैमरा वन विच शोज द मूवमेंट, शोज द ब्राइटनेस ऑफ बल्ब. As the switch is off, when the circuit is closed, when the circuit is open, the bulb has no brightness at all. The galvanometer needle shows null, zero. Okay. When the switch is on, the bulb starts glowing. But not instantly. It takes some time to reach its maximum brightness. Okay. So, very small amount of brightness and the galvanometer needle get deflected. With time, the brightness of this bulb increases. With time, the brightness of this bulb increases and the deflection in galvanometer also increases. Again, the brightness of bulb increases to its maximum value, and the galvanometer needle get deflected to its maximum value, then there is no further increase in the brightness of bulb with time. There is no more deflection in the galvanometer. Now the brightness of the bulb and the deflection in galvanometer becomes constant. There is no change in brightness or the reading of galvanometer. Up to this point, what happens? The brightness increases. What happens to the galvanometer? The reading of galvanometer increases. And then the brightness of bulb become constant and the reading of galvanometer become constant. There is no further increase in brightness of bulb and the deflection of galvanometer. If I draw a graph between current and the time, how will this graph be? Time as usual on x-axis and the current I on y-axis. Initially the current is zero. The current gradually rises up to its maximum value. It takes a very small time, fraction of second, and then the current become constant. The current become constant, it does not change with the time. Na ghatni hai na badhni hai. This is called steady current. Why does it not increases to its maximum value instantly? It's a different point, because there are many factors acting in the circuits. So it takes a very small time to reach its maximum value. This time depends on the property of circuit, what kind of circuit it is. So this is steady current set up by a source of steady EMF. Remember, current is the consequence. The real source behind the setup of current is the EMF. This is the constant current set by a source of constant EMF. Clear? Now what happens to a AC circuit? What happens when this experiment is repeated to AC circuit? Again, I have a bulb, normal incandescent bulb, filament bulb. I have a bulb and a source of alternating EMF. It is represented by this symbol. It is taken from the graph, from sine graph. देखिए आप ध्यान से, दिस इज द साइन ग्राफ ऑफ इंड्यूस्ड ईएमएफ. सो इट बिकम्स द सिंबल ऑफ एसी. देयर इज अ स्विच, राइट, एंड अ गैल्वेनोमीटर इन सीरीज. दिस इज द गैल्वेनोमीटर, दिस इज स्विच, एंड व्हेनेवर यू राइट अ सोर्स ऑफ ईएमएफ, हियर यू हैव टू राइट ई, which represent a source of constant EMF. When you make a symbol of alternating current, you have to write what E equals E naught sine omega t. E equals E naught sine omega t. It is necessary. Again, I have placed two cameras, one in front of galvanometer, C2 camera, and the other in front of bulb. So what will happen? Now see the difference between alternating current and direct current. Initially the brightness of bulb is zero and the deflection in galvanometer is zero. Here the brightness of bulb is zero and the diffraction in galvanometer is also zero. Correct. The current in galvanometer increases. The current shows, the galvanometer shows increasing diffraction and this bulb shows some brightness. Again, the current through galvanometer increases in magnitude, the brightness of bulb increases. Further, the current in galvanometer again increases and the brightness of bulb increases to its maximum value. Maximum value. This is the rise of current. This is the growth of current. This is the rise of current. Then what happens? The current through galvanometer start decreasing. The brightness of bulb start decreasing. What is this part? This is the time span. This is the instant when the current, when the EMF undercurrent is growing. From time 0 to time T by 4, the current is growing, beacon reaches its maximum value, the brightness of the bulb also increasing, becomes maximum. Then the EMF starts dropping and as the current also start decreasing, the current start decreasing, the brightness of bulb start decreasing. The current decreases, the brightness further decreases. The current decreases, the brightness further decreases, and then the current become zero and there is no brightness in the bulb. Normally we don't feel. In real, a normal bulb goes off 100 times in 1 second. 1 second mein 100 baar bujh jata hai bulb. 100 baar jalta hai, 100 baar bujhta hai. Lekin hum isko recognize nahi kar sakte because of persistence of either. The galvanometer reading become zero again. This is the time T equals 0 and this is the time T equals what? T by 4. The current is in a tendency to increase. Then the current start decreasing. This is at a time when it becomes time, it becomes what? T by 2. The time is T by 4. Here the time is 0. Now the positive half of AC is completed. Which half? This one. The growth of EMF, the growth of current from 0 to a certain maximum value, and the fall of EMF, the fall of current from that maximum value to 0. This is called the positive half of AC. This is called positive half. Positive half of AC is completed. Now, what happens when this negative half appears in the circuit? Again, the reading of galvanometer starts increasing. Again, the reading of galvanometer starts increasing. But now the diffraction is in opposite direction. If the current in this positive half, current during this positive half is clockwise in the circuit. Now the clock, the current start in opposite direction, anti-clockwise. The EMF and the current reverse is direction. there is small brightness, a little brightness in the bulb. Then the diffraction of galvanometer further increases, which shows growth of current, and the brightness of this bulb also increases. Current further increases, the brightness of bulb further increases, then the current reach its maximum value and the brightness of the bulb reach its maximum value. Here again there is increase of current, increase in opposite direction, increase in opposite direction. Here is the time equals what? 3T/4. At exactly time t equals 3T/4, the current reaches the EMF and hence the current reaches its maximum value. The brightness of the bulb again reaches its maximum value. This is the negative half of AC. Then what happens again? The current start decreasing. Since the EMF is in decreasing tendency, the brightness of the bulb start decreasing. The current further decreases. The brightness of bulb further decreases. And ultimately, the current reduces to zero and there is no brightness in the bulb. This is the time when one cycle of AC has been completed. So this part here, in this part, the current is in decreasing tendency. The increase of current to its maximum value and then decreasing to its value zero. This whole time is positive half of AC. Then the current changes its direction, the EMF reverses its direction, increase to its maximum value, then decreases to zero. This is negative half of AC. So in an AC circuit, the brightness of your bulb, whether it is LED or something other, it is not constant. It keeps on increasing and decreasing. In one time period, in one complete cycle, there are two instant when the current becomes zero. One cycle of AC in our normal electricity, one cycle of AC is completed in 1/50 seconds. Just 1/50 second. It takes 50 this kind of cycles, 50 cycles in 1 second. It means there are 50 instants when the current is clockwise, there are another 50 instants when the current is in anticlockwise direction. In every cycle there are 2 instants when the EMF and the current becomes zero, your bulb goes off. But this happened very fast, so we cannot recognize it. This is actually what happens in the circuit. In AC circuit, the current is never constant. It keeps on fluctuating. It keeps on changing from zero to its maximum value. So what is this maximum value? It depends upon the resistance, your EMF, or some other factors. What will be the maximum value? But it is sure that the current is not constant. The current increases from zero to a certain maximum value, then reduces to zero again. Then the direction of current is reversed. Reaches its maximum value again and then reduces to zero. In a steady source, in a steady current, once the current rises to its maximum value does not change with time. It keeps on constant depending upon that your EMF, the source of EMF is large enough to give you current for a long time.